Hello, my fellow graduating class of 2017, family, friends, and faculty. Thank you all so much for entrusting me with the honor of speaking to you on one of the most important days of your lives. This is our story of struggle, of hope, and of triumph. Our journey to June 12 began the moment we stepped foot on Watkins soil as hopelessly awkward freshmen. From our braces to our cringe-worthy fashion statements, we roll in the halls with palms clenched to our 50-pound backpacks as if we were carrying our entire lives. We got a little better as sophomores. We walked a little taller with a bit more swagger, but that slight underclassman stench still lingered. Junior year came along and we were now crowned with the oh-so-coveted title of being upperclassmen. In a year, we would be seniors, kings and queens. We would rise as Wolverines and claim the glorious kingdom of Watkinsville. But for each of us, there was a certain aspect of this thing called school that we had to overcome. For some, it was a social aspect. For some, it was the transition. For some, it was a test, the workload, the course material. And for others, like myself, it was the dreaded beast, IB. Like any relationship, we have had our ups and our share of downs with this thing called school. We have stayed up because of school. We have fought with school. We have cried because of school. We have contemplated how the heck we got ourselves involved with school in the first place. And yes, we have threatened to break up with school, but never quite grew the guts to do so. So we stuck with school, and by the shared grace of God, made it through. Einstein once said that education is not the learning of facts, but it is the training of the mind to think. To your surprise, you may come to realize that you are now better at thinking than you were 4 years ago. Whether or not we remember the difference between synecdoche and metonymy, or that the derivative of cosine is negative sine, we must know that we were blessed with the mentors and the teachers who saw untapped potential and nurtured it, who propelled us to walk in the paths of the history makers of yesterday, who taught us to be unafraid and unashamed to be the game changers of today, who have equipped us to become the leaders of tomorrow. For many of us, this is our redemption story. Like a young girl losing her father before she even reaches middle school, she fights to be the young woman that he would have been proud to call his daughter. She continues to rise. Like a boy and his family, growing up in a completely foreign country, against all odds, fought their way to land in the country of promise. Coming from virtually nothing, he manages to graduate in the top 5% of his class. He continues to rise. Like a young man whose loved ones are fighting a daily battle with cancer, but with unshakable faith believes that the actions he takes today can one day save their lives. With selflessness, he yearns to place an unbreakable smile on the faces of everyone he encounters. He continues to rise. And like this simple Ghanaian girl, losing her grandfather to the hands of a man she was trying to help, she finds herself 3 years later standing before her peers at graduation to celebrate their triumphant achievement. She continues to rise. This, my friends, is our redemption story. Marked as underdogs, we as a high school joined hands to take a knee for a cause we saw was worth fighting for. Marked as underdogs, we rose above every circumstance that came our way. And marked as underdogs, we have made it to our graduation day. For the past 4 years, we have been marked as underdogs, but today, we are champions. We are champions of every shade, of every gender, of every ethnicity, of every socioeconomic background. Because today, I see writers whose stories have yet to be penned. Teachers whose knowledge has yet to be shared, musicians whose songs have yet to be sung, travelers whose journeys have only begun. I see artists whose canvases have yet to be filled, doctors whose hands have yet to heal. I see engineers whose ideas have yet to be realized, champions whose greatness has yet to be epitomized. Because for so long we have been marked as underdogs, but today we are champions. I do not see underdogs any longer. I see people ready to use their world as their platform. I see history makers and world changers. I see you, Watkinsville. I see us. So today I charge you, Watkins Mills, graduating class of 2017, to be relentless givers, be passionate thinkers, be unashamed dreamers, be unafraid risk takers. Go forth, channel your greatness, and be the champions of your world. Thank you all so much.